MCP is a protocol that allows AI agents to take actions on your behalf with specific instructions. What we're going to do is walk through how to set up the resend MCP server on Cursor, and that way you can tell Cursor to send an email using your resend account. We'll first build the server, then we'll connect it to Cursor by providing our API key that will then allow Cursor to take this action of sending an email on our behalf anywhere in our local system. You ready? Let's go. To get started, we're going to clone and build this local repo. In other words, it's not going to be available online somewhere. We're going to use this within our own system because we're using it in Cursor Desktop. I'll include a link to the repo below, but go ahead and then just clone this repo however you typically do that on your machine. So in my terminal of choice, I'll go ahead and clone this, and then I'll CD directly into it. Now, the next thing we need to do is to build this locally. So I'll npm install and npm run build. And what this will do is produce a finished file at build index.js. So let's go ahead and open this up in Cursor. And you'll see that's exactly what we've got over here. I've now got this built file here that this is what we're going to point everything else to. This is currently the way we've set it up to give you full control over this server. You'll simply point Cursor Desktop then to this finished built file, and it will use that to then send emails on your behalf. Now, to point Cursor to this finished built file, I need to open up the Cursor settings. I'll open the command palette and just simply type Cursor settings. It happens to be at the top of mine as well. Then you'll go to MCP, and you're going to add a new global MCP server. Now, the nice thing is we have everything we need in the README over here, so I don't have to remember what this looks like. You can jump over here and just copy this as well. You can name it whatever you want. I've just named it resend, so I'll open this back up and simply drop this directly in here. Now, notice we've got a type of command, we've got a node, and then we've got a few things we can change out. I'll need to provide an absolute path to the built file, which we'll do in a second, and then I also need a resend API key. So let's start with this first one. I can grab an absolute path by right-clicking and selecting copy path. Then the last thing I need is a resend API key. You can get a resend API key from your resend account. So here I am in my resend account. I've selected API keys on the left, and I can just create a new API key. I'll name this Cursor Desktop just so I remember kind of what it's for. And then I'll click Add. Now you can only see this once, and that's a security measure because anybody who has access to this key can send emails on your behalf and get access to your account. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this. And in my case, just to show you what this is going to look like, I'll paste it in for you to see, but you don't want to share this with anyone. I'll delete this as soon as the video is done. Back over in Cursor Desktop, I'm simply going to paste the key directly here. Again, you should not share this with anyone, and I'll delete mine after the video. These are the only two required arguments, but you can actually pass in several other things as well. If I jump back over to the README, you'll see that we've got a key. We've already provided that, but you can also provide a sender and a reply to email address. Both of these are optional, but if you don't include the sender, it will actually ask you who you want to send this from. Resend requires you set up your custom domain before you say you can send from that domain. So in other words, I can only send from onboarding@resend.dev until I've set up my own custom domain. So let's look at that now. I'm back in my resend account, and you can see I've got a custom domain here. If you haven't set one up, you can set one up by simply adding the DNS records, which when you go to create one, it'll actually just prompt you with all these. You can add these one at a time, and it'll even give you often links to the documentation to do that. It usually takes a couple of minutes to verify, and then you're set and ready to go. That means I can send from updates.chris/resend.com instead of the default onboarding@resend.dev. I'm going to jump back over here, and we'll use the sender argument as well. So I'll use sender, and I'm just going to say chris@updates.resend.com. Now, this is not actually an email account that I can manage, which means I'll also want to use this other optional argument of reply to. For that, I'll just reply to chris@resend.com, which is my own personal work address. That means when people receive this email, it will come from my custom domain, and when they reply, it will go into my work inbox. Finally, let's restart Cursor, and then we can use it in any chat. With Cursor reset here, you can see that under MCP servers, it now says that this is valid and working. Now, I can use this in any repo. It doesn't have to be this repo, but since we've got this email test, I can go ahead and use this. So let's do this. Let's say let's send it to chris@resend.com, and then I'll just select all this, hit Command L to enter a new chat, and say, send this to me. Cursor will look at the tools it has available, realize it can send an email, and then in this case, it's asking me if I want to CC or BCC anyone. I'll just say no, and we'll send it out straight away. And notice how it calls that tool. And in fact, if I were to look at this tool and expand it, you can see exactly what it's going to do. And I'll simply click Run Tool. Now I get back the response, this email has been sent successfully, but let's go ahead and verify that as well. There are two places I want to verify this. One would be the resend dashboard. So here I am in my emails tab, and you can see I've got this test email that's been delivered, and I can actually preview it if I want to as well. It was just plain text in this case, so that's all I see over this way. I've got insights as well if I want to do better, for instance, adding a DMARC record, but all this comes built in with Resend. The other place I'd want to check is my email inbox. Notice I can see this here in my own inbox. It's coming from my custom domain, but if I go ahead and click reply, notice it replies to chris@resend.com because that's the instruction we gave the MCP server. So when would you actually use an MCP server like this? In our case, we've just selected text and told it to send it to us. But you could see how you could build this into automations or any workflows anytime you're using Cursor Desktop to send reports to your team or run queries and then send those out to clients. This is the kind of thing you can do, and it's just the beginning. Let us know what you want to do more with this MCP server as we continue to develop it. Thanks for watching. We'll catch you in the next one. Happy sending.